fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars.
So here we are at Capitol Studios, where so many of these great Frank Sinatra albums were recorded. To do an album of Frank Sinatra's music, when you listen to this music, it was perfection, you know? And to have a chance to get into it, it just raises everybody's game up.
I love you. Yes, I do.
Quincy and the Sinatra family asked me to sing this song at the Hollywood Bowl this season on the opening night when Frank was inducted into the Hollywood Bowl Hall of Fame. And that kind of started us down this whole road of making this album.
Let's take it nice and easy.
I'm Alan Bergman, and my wife, Marilyn, and composer by the name of Lou Spence, wrote this song that Steve is recording now, Nice and Easy. First recorded by this fellow over my shoulder here. And oddly enough, in the same studio.
The problem now, of course, is to simply hold your horses. To rush would be a crime.
I'm going to record Elton on the first or second week in September. He's singing Making Whoopee with Rod.
My favorite singer in the world, right here.
I was in New York, I'm working with Rod. I worked with Rod today, we did two songs.
He's trying to make how he knows what he's doing.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
He's what we call a producer.
Producer, that's it, that's me. Bill Claxton right here, who has photographed this album, and my first album, my last album.
And your future album.
And my future albums I haven't even made yet.
I'd known this, I would have shaved.
And that's Bill's photograph from when, 1953, you said?
1954. Yeah. That's when the studio first opened.
Something indicative of when this was written in the style. Notice the chart is written in two instead of four. It's really given its age away, but Cy Oliver, you know. I would give you one and two. All right, then we have on the downbeat next one, Brian.
Somebody else.
They have done this studio over again several times. They've done the control room over more times. And the men's room down the hall is the same it was in 1956.
One I love belongs to somebody else.
Man like the bear, you ain't nowhere. That's why
she sings her songs to somebody else.
Boo hoo hoo hoo.
And even when I had my arms around her,
well, man, you know,
her thoughts are for somebody else. And when I hold her hand, I know they belong to someone.
Someone.
Somebody else.
And you can bet
they're not so cold to somebody else.
Well, tough to be alone on a shelf,
and it's worse to be in love by yourself. Like when the one you love belongs to somebody else.
I mean, if it wasn't for the Sinatra family, I would never ever do this. But Frank Jr., from my first album on, supported me and told me to keep doing it.
When you're lonely, has learned its lesson, you'd be hers if only she would call. In the wee small hours of the morning, that's the time you miss her. Oh.
Oh, well, they're the best musicians in the world, you know, and a lot of them played on the original recordings.
Those fingers in my hair, that sly come here the stare, that strips my conscience bare, it's witchcraft. And I've got no defense for it, the heat is too intense for it. What good would common sense for it do? Cause it's witchcraft, wicked witchcraft.
This music has no expiration date, you know, it just thrills me to be doing music that was originally recorded 50 years ago and see it reach a new audience of younger people that realize how great it is. I really believe that these Sinatra recordings and these wonderful songs are America's greatest contribution to the arts. And it's really up to us to keep this music going forever.
I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near. In spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. Just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. Cause I've got you under my skin.